So now that I've made up the DIY sensor, I'm going to actually fit this to the bike now, and we're going to undergo an initial trial and see how it works out. So the plan is to fit the particle sensor itself to the front of the bike, just by the air intake, and actually try and find out exactly what's going in through that intake, see if we can get an idea of how many particles are actually going through the system itself. So this is the sensor, and this is where we're going to be placing the sensor, just here, right at the front. I didn't want to obstruct the air intake, but if we just place it just below, it should give us a good representation of what's actually going through in this direction here. Right, the trick is now is to feed these cables through without disrupting the steering or the suspension. So if I feed that through there, the trick is to make sure that all this cabling is pretty well hidden, secure, it's not going to chafe on anything. It basically stays out of the way. It just may require me just to remove a few of the panels to get at it. Now, for the purposes of this exercise, I've got some sticky foamy bits to try and attach to the front here. I generally don't like anything sticky stuck to the bike, because it's usually a bit of a bugger to get off. But because I've got nothing else at the moment, and it's probably the best thing to use, to be honest, it's very sticky and it's not going to go anywhere once it's stuck. I'm going to trial it and see how it goes. So, take these off. That's an awkward one. Sorry. Need two hands. Right, okay, so that's the sticky, and we're going to stick that to the front like so. Nice and tight. So it gets some kind of perspective of where that sensor is. There we go. Now, in the event of this thing actually, if it did come unattached, I don't want to lose it, and I don't want it going into the braking system and making me come off. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to tape this, some of the cabling, to the underneath, just to secure that a bit better. And I'm going to do that all the way around. Try and make that nice and tidy. Okay, we'll put the infill panel back in. Make sure that cable's out of the way. Now, for the purpose of this test, we're going to feed the sensor cable through to the back here, and this lifts off. It reveals a nice little space where our control box can actually fit, and we can connect the cable. Now, on the main trip itself, there's going to be six of these. They won't all fit in the back of the bike that I'll be hiring. So the idea is to use what we call a tank bag or a pouch. And what we'll do, we'll fit this on the front here. And this fits quite snugly. It's magnetic, so it will stick to a steel tank very securely. And the control boxes will actually go into the pouch itself. So I'm trying to keep it as neat and as uncomplicated as possible, and as fairly maintenance free as possible. Now, these control boxes are fitted to the cable by a 6-pin connector, and all I have to do is basically plug in and plug out when I've finished each sample run.